Hi, Rick Wallace here for the Pajarito Environmental Education Center in Los Alamos, New Mexico. Today, we will discuss a few current and historical celebrations around the world that are associated with the summer solstice. Let me start by talking a little bit about one of the most famous petroglyph sites in Chaco Canyon, the Dagger of Light. There are many Native American petroglyphs that are indicators of summer and winter solstices and played a significant role in ancient agricultural calendars. And you can see here the one at Chaco Canyon kind of pierces this petroglyph sun symbol during the summer solstice. We also have a petroglyph near White Rock, New Mexico, that is in the summer, a sun petroglyph, and there is a shadow of a rock, a pointer rock, that moves toward the center of this petroglyph during summer solstice. This will give you an idea of the size of that petroglyph. It's about 3 feet in diameter. Now, in ancient Egypt, the summer solstice preceded the appearance of the star Sirius, which rose at dawn about 2 weeks after the solstice. And the Egyptians believed that this was responsible for the annual flooding of the Nile that they relied upon for agriculture. Because of this, the Egyptian calendar was set so that the start of the year coincided with the appearance of Sirius just after the solstice. Roman Midsummer Festival of Vestalia honored Vesta, the Roman goddess who guarded the family and was considered the patron of the domestic sphere. In the first day of this festival, married women were allowed to enter the temple of the Vestal Virgins, from which they were barred for the rest of the year. The ancient Greek festival of Kronia honored Cronus, the god of agriculture. This festival was distinguished from other annual feasts and celebrations in that slaves and free men participated in the festivities as equals, very unusual at that time. Now, in terms of Greek mythology, Cronus, or the Roman Saturn, was the son of Uranus and Gaia, the earth. He killed his father, Uranus, and became king of the gods. He was overthrown by his son Zeus, which the Romans knew as Jupiter, the god of thunder and lightning. Hence, we have the order of the planets as they are named in our outer solar system, Jupiter, Saturn, and Uranus. Jupiter, his father Saturn, and his grandfather Uranus. Many summer solstice festivals around the world have some common themes. One is bonfires, to light the shorter days to come, to cleanse those who jump through the fire, and so on. Dancing, singing, and music are common, and celebrations of family and community, including storytelling around the bonfire, are very common. And the Orthodox Church appropriated the pagan Midsummer as St. John's Day, June 24th. During Roman times, this fell a little bit different time. But the point is that many of these festivals are named for St. John's Day or St. John's Eve, and others are named for the summer solstice. Klydonas in Greece is very interesting. The custom of Klydonas has its roots in ancient times. Single women would gather around and an oracle would give them a clue to the identity of their future husband. The word Klydonas derives from the ancient word Klydon, which it refers to the words of prophecy. I'll just make a quick side note that the big drum they were playing there is called a davul, and it happens to be one of my hobbies to play that drum, sometimes also known as a tapan in Bulgaria. All right, moving on. The Slavic traditions also have something very similar. Kupala night is celebrated in Ukraine, Belarus, Lithuania, Poland, and Russia. The holiday, originally Kupala, it was a pagan fertility rite, later accepted into the Orthodox Christian calendar on the night before St. John's Day. Many of the rites related to this holiday within Slavic religion beliefs were connected with the role of water and ritual purification. Young people would jump over the flames of bonfires in a ritual test of bravery and faith. The failure of a couple in love to complete the jump while holding hands was a sign of their destined separation. Girls may float wreaths of flowers, often lit with candles, on the rivers and would attempt to gain foresight into their relationship and the fortunes of their future relationships from the flow patterns of the flowers on the river. Men may attempt to capture the wreaths in the hope of capturing the interests of the woman who floated that particular wreath. Jumping over the fire for ritual purification and fertility was part of many of these Eastern European rituals. White clothing signifies purity and maidenhood. The pagan druid robes are often white, owing to white's association with the sun. Here's a short video of all the celebrations. So that couple seems to be secure. In St. Petersburg, Russia, St. Petersburg is only about 450 miles south of the Arctic Circle, so the twilight never really ends during the solstice, and I've been there during that time period. It's very, very strange and eerie lighting in the sky where you can wander around town basically all night if you want to and see where you're going. The White Nights Festival in St. Petersburg is marked by fireworks. The summer solstice celebration in Poznań, Poland includes lighting candles inside these basically paper balloons and floating them across the river. Probably not a good idea in New Mexico, but apparently in Europe and especially Eastern Europe, they had a lot more rain than we have. Definitely something for a more humid climate that we have here. Also in Poland, as in Russia and Slavic country, other Slavic countries, they have the women make wreaths to float down the river.
Każdino. Chyba.
So the singing and dancing continues throughout the day. Now we'll talk a little bit about summer solstice celebrations in Scandinavia. And if you don't have the appropriate dreams, perhaps you picked the wrong flowers. Here are midsummer bonfires in Finland for Sankt Hans Aften, St. John's Day, evening actually. Bonfires on the beach in Scandinavia. One story was that the Swedes had bonfires on the beaches to send the witches back over to Germany. The bonfire world record is held in, by Alesund, Norway, where the flames reached 155.5 feet in height. Germany and Austria also have the bonfire tradition, and it's really spectacular to look at the bonfires in the Austrian Alps burning during the early evenings. Now, Germany, Austria, Switzerland, Bavaria would roll these burning wheels down the hillside. And in fact, this is also a Slavic tradition in Belarus, Ukraine, Russia, and so on. If the burning wheel made it all the way down to the river without burning out, there would be an abundant vintage or harvest that year. Again, not something to try in drier climates. This is a midsummer festival in Romania. Again, note the white dresses. And of course, we can't talk about this without talking about Stonehenge and Britons and Celts and so on. The solstice sunrise over the hillstone at Stonehenge is perhaps one of the best known ancient markers for an astronomical event. You can see the photo of this. Here is the hillstone in the center of the photo. And this is the geometry where the light comes in from the rising sun over the hillstone and hits the altar stone dead center. These are some modern pagans and onlookers at Stonehenge during the summer solstice sunrise. And of course, you have to account for daylight savings time. Easier now than it was in those days. In the U.S., we have also summer solstice celebrations, parades, parties, music, dance, and so on. Here's a picture from the Virginia Summer Solstice Festival. It was also designated a few years ago as the International Day of Yoga, where Times Square in New York was completely filled with yoga participants. Santa Barbara, of course, has swimming festivals. And in Alaska, the Alaska Gold Panners, or Fairbanks, now have this all-night solstice baseball. They took it over in 1960 to carry on a tradition that was actually begun in 1906. And the baseball team, most northerly baseball team on the planet, starts with the game at 10 p.m. and stretches well into the following morning without the need for any artificial artificial light. It is known as the Midnight Sun Game. So those are just a few of the many historical and current traditions celebrating the summer solstice. And again, I'm Rick Wallace from the Pajarito Environmental Education Center, wishing you a super solstice.